Hi everyone, welcome to Mash Math. Today we are going to study chapter 11 constructions, exercise 11.1, question 2. Construct a triangle of sides 4 cm, 5 cm, 6 cm and then a triangle similar to it whose sides are 2 upon 3 of the corresponding sides of the first triangle. I have explained to you in the introduction part 2 how to construct a similar triangle corresponding to the triangle of the given triangle. Okay, so first what we will do, first is let us construct a triangle of the sides having this. So whenever they give you like that, the best thing is first you draw any side you can take, but then the biggest one will take first. Okay, so we'll take the 6 cm as a base. Okay, 6 cm. Okay, this is 6 cm. Let's name this as A and B. Please write down all these details because it's very important, otherwise your marks will be cut. So 6 cm. Now we'll take 5 cm in your compass. Okay, adjust your compass. 5 cm you have to take. Okay, so 5 cm. And draw the arc. Okay, so now you take 4 cm. Because 5 cm had taken, now let's take 4 cm. Okay, from this side now and cut. Okay, this is your point C and join now. Okay, so we have constructed a triangle. Construct a triangle of sides 4 cm, 5 cm, 6. So this is 4 cm. This is 5 cm. In the introduction, I have taught you that when you have to divide the line, when you have to do the division of the line segment, what we do, the ratio, we will sum up the ratio and that many parts we have to make it. But if you have to draw a similar triangle, okay, similar triangle, when we have to draw, then what we do, the biggest number we will see, and if it is biggest number 4, then we made 4 parts. If the biggest number is 5, then we made 5 parts. So please go through the introduction, then it will be easy for you to understand. So here what we have to do, we have constructed a triangle. Now we have to construct a similar triangle, that of 2 upon 3. So the biggest number is here 3. So we have to make a 3 parts. So let's draw an acute angle and name it as X. Now we have to divide them into equal parts, that is how many? 3 parts. Biggest number is 3, so 3 parts. So take any measure of in your compass and then divide them into equally 3 parts. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so after doing, we name it this. This is A. So this will be A1, A2, A3. So now what we have to do, we have to see in denominator what is there. Denominator we have 3. So 3 we will join with the B. So 3 is here, so we join with B. Okay, now to this line, that is A3 and B, we have to draw a parallel line. Please go through the introduction kindly. In detail I have explained to you. So what we have to do to draw a parallel line, first we have to draw the angle for this line. So take any measure and draw the angle. Once you draw the angle for this, now next point where we have to draw, look here, 3 we have finished, so on 2 we have to draw the angle. So 2 is here, so keep on that point and draw the angle. Sorry. So now what we will do, we have to measure this angle now. So let's measure this angle. How much is this angle? Okay, after measuring, same measurement will take this angle also. Okay, so we have measured. Now join this point and point 2. Okay, so we have drawn a parallel to this line, parallel we have drawn. So this point will be here B, so this becomes our B dash. So next what we have to do, we have to draw parallel to this line, we have to draw another line parallel. So same procedure, take the compass, on B you keep and draw an angle. Okay, the same measurement, keep on B dash and draw the angle. Okay, now measure this angle. How much is this angle? Okay, same measurement you take here also. Okay, so now join this point and this point. So this is C, means this will be C dash. So let's highlight this. So this is the triangle we have constructed just now, a similar triangle, that is of 2 upon 3 sides of the given triangle. So we have constructed A, C dash and B dash. So I told you in the introduction, when numerator is smaller, the triangle that you construct will be smaller. It will come inside the triangle. Actually you constructed, this is the given triangle, then similar triangle when we constructed, it comes inside of that triangle, because numerator is small, so the triangle will come inside. Now next what you have to do is write the steps. It is compulsory, few steps you need to write down. Steps. First what we did, we constructed line segment AB, right? Draw AB line segment of 6 cm. Then what we did, with draw the arc, no? We keeping B as a center, we drew the arc of 5 cm. Okay. Keeping B as center, draw the arc of 5 cm. Then what we did, keeping A as a center, we cut that arc of 4 cm. Okay, keeping A as center, draw the arc of 4 cm. Okay, fourth, what we did, where the both the arc cut, that becomes point C, where both the arc cut, that becomes point C. Okay, then what we did, so we construct a triangle ABC. You can mention that also. Thus, triangle ABC constructed. Okay, next what we did, we drew this ray AX. So you can say draw AX ray. Okay, then what we did, we divided into how many part? 1, 2, 3 part. Okay, so divide into 3 parts and name them A1, A2, A3. Okay, then what we did, then we constructed a parallel line A3 and B. Okay, or join A3 with B. Then what we did, then constructed the parallel line A to B dash we constructed. Okay, so you can write 8, right? 9th point, construct A to B dash parallel to A3 and B. For this parallel, we constructed this. Then what we did? Then we constructed for this a parallel line, this. Okay? So, 10th point, construct BC parallel to B dash C dash. Okay? So, after we constructed this, we got the required triangle. Thus, we got the required triangle, that is A, B dash and C dash. That's it. So steps you write in your own word as you are doing your work. Okay, it is not compulsory you have to write this way, only in your own word you write down what you have done it. Nobody is going to read each line. Okay, so now if justification is asked, then you have to do the justification. In your textbook it is asked. I have not mentioned here, but in your textbook in beginning only the title mentioned it is. See, each of the following give the justification of the construction. So you have to give the justification. In the exam if it is asked, then only you give. Okay, so now justification. So justification, how it is, I have explained to you introduction in clearly that when you draw a triangle, you see if this is the triangle, we constructed this parallel line. So whenever in a triangle you construct a parallel line of one side of the triangle, then this parallel line will divide both the side into equal ratio. That means this side will be equal to this side will be equal to this side. So that is called basic proportionality theorem. Okay, so that's what we are going to apply here. So A3 and B is parallel to A2 and B dash, therefore since this is parallel to this, so this ratio becomes equal. Okay, so that means A2 upon A2 A3 will be equal to A B dash upon B dash B by basic proportionality theorem. This becomes equation 1 and this is what actually this we have constructed. Okay, this we have constructed 2 parts and 1 part. Okay, so 2 by 1 by construction. this becomes equation 2. From see, this is same, and therefore this also will be equal to each other. So therefore, from equation 1 and 2, you can say a b dash upon b dash b is equal to 2 upon 1. Now you write the reciprocal. So whenever small one comes, you write the reciprocal, because we want, afterwards you will come to know, 1 by 2. Okay, this reciprocal. So we have proved that this is 2 part and this is a b dash. Okay, a b dash. This is okay. A b b dash. This is 2 and this is 1 part. Okay, this is what we have written. But we have to prove that this side is of 2 upon 3 ratio, this side. So once you prove this is 2 upon 3, then we can prove the other sides are also 2 upon 3. Okay. So now, biggest side is AB. Okay. AB. This is smallest side. AB dash is equal to, AB can be written as this plus this. So AB dash plus B dash B upon, this is AB dash. Okay. Separately, let us write down, plus B dash B upon AB dash. This gets cancelled. So we will get what? 1 plus, this is B dash B. See? That's why I wrote the reciprocal. 1 upon 2. Okay. That will give us, if you take LCM, 2, 2 plus 1 upon 2. So that means AB upon AB dash. This is what we are proceeding, is equal to 3 upon 2. So 3 upon 2. Now this you write the reciprocal. That is AB dash upon AB is equal to 2 upon 3. Because we have to prove 2 upon 3. This what we have constructed is 2 upon 3 we have to prove. That's why AB dash upon AB. Okay. See, AB dash upon AB. Reciprocally write down 2 upon 3. We have proved now this. So now by angle criteria, you can say this triangle is similar to this triangle. So triangle ABC is similar to triangle AB dash and C dash. Okay. So I'll continue here. Okay. So if they are similar, then by angle, they become similar means then their ratio also becomes equal. Okay. So that is the case. This is what we have constructed. So we will write AB dash upon AB is equal to AC dash upon AC. Then C1B1 upon C dash B dash upon CB. Okay. So I'll write down this first. This is what we have constructed. So therefore, AB dash upon AB is equal to AC dash upon AC. Then C dash B dash upon CB. Okay. This last line you have to write down here. So that's it. I hope it is clear to you. Thank you. God bless you.